Have you accidentally deleted your files or they have suddenly disappeared from your SD card? If so, I have some great news for you. Today, we'll look at recovering deleted photos from an SD card. And in my case, I've lost my files plenty of times as I shoot more pictures and videos all of the time. But I have tried and tested many different ways to get my lost data back. And eventually, the only solution that worked for me was using a data recovery software. Before we start the recovery process, we first have to do three things. Firstly, if you've accidentally formatted or deleted photos from your SD card, it's important to stop using the SD card immediately. Each new file written to the card could potentially overwrite the data that you are trying to recover, which reduces the chances of successfully recovering the files. Secondly, go ahead and take your SD card out of your camera, phone, or whichever device it's in. You don't want anything accidentally saved on it and messing up your chances of getting those photos back. Now that we have got the SD card all safe and sound, how do we get those pictures back? That's where a good recovery tool comes into play. You'll need something to scan your SD card and see if there's anything to be saved. Now, I recommend using Disk Drill. It has a free version which can give you your SD card a deep dive and show you what photos you are able to recover. Now, the reason that I use Disk Drill is because I like the simple and convenient UI. Disk Drill has also demonstrated excellent results for recovery and supports popular formats such as RAW, CRW, CR2, CR3, NEF, NRW, ARW, SRF, SR2, and other file formats. The latest version of Disk Drill supports and is fully optimized for macOS Ventura. Disk Drill is also available on both Mac and Windows PC. And in fact, if you are a Windows user, you can recover up to 500 megabytes of data for free. I have my SD card right here and I'll be restoring my deleted photos from it. Now, please know that you can follow the steps that I'm following on my MacBook exactly the same way if you have a Windows machine. So here are the steps to recover deleted photos from an SD card. So when you're scanning your SD card, it's necessary to connect it directly to a computer and not scan it while it's still in the device. This is because most new devices use Media Transfer Protocol, also known as MTP, which does not allow direct scanning of device memory and memory cards. Now, once we start the scanning process, you can see this tab with the color icons, and this is divided into different file types. This shows the real-time scan results and the estimated time to complete the scanning process. We can also select the tab with the files that we want to check and right-click the button at the top right of our screen called Review Found Items. And this will take us to our scan results. And we can review exactly what Disk Drill was able to find. Now, please wait until the scanning process has been completed before clicking on this button and recovering the files. Now, once the scanning process wraps up, you'll see the results laid out, deleted or lost and reconstructed. The existing category is all about the files still hanging out on the memory card or haven't been deleted. Sometimes you'll even find some files you didn't even know were there, hidden away. In the deleted or lost category, these are files that Disk Drill managed to dig up with a deep scan. Please keep in mind that each data loss case is unique and your scan results may look slightly different to mine. Finally, we have the reconstructed folder, files found using a signature scan. These files may not have their original names or have random names such as a date or default values. Right in the middle, you'll notice a column called recovery chances. This isn't just showing you which files are recoverable, it's also giving you a heads up on how intact that they'll be if you restore them. In other words, it's telling you if they'll work properly once you get them back on your card. Now on the right side, we've got a super handy feature, the file preview. This is where you get to see a sneak peek of the recovered file. It's pretty convenient, especially when you're dealing with the files that have lost their original names. If you have some trouble finding your files, Disk Drill has these filters, which you can use to find the desired file by name, date of modification, or type of file. Or you can also click the Recover All button to recover all files immediately. Now that we've picked up the file that we want to bring back to life, there's an important detail to remember. You've got to make sure you're not trying to restore the file to the same SD card that you're recovering it from. Think of it as a no-go zone for now. Instead, choose a different save location like your computer's hard drive or another storage device. This way, you stay clear of accidentally overwriting any more data on your original SD card. So once your file is restored, you can open up the folder like this and verify the integrity of the file to make sure it's the one that you've lost and is the correct file size and matches what you were trying to recover. From here, you can move your file to your local folders, rename it if needed, and start using it. That was a tutorial on how to recover deleted photos. If you like it and it helped you, then please give this video a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and drop a comment below for any questions. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.